These first 2 days of practice, man, like, please.
Oh, it's been great. It's been super fun, super energetic. Everybody's energy has been on like a 10 every day. So, I mean, it's been a lot of fun, honestly.
What are some of the things you've learned so far here?
Really just like how much freedom they have, knowing that anybody can bring the ball up, get into the offense. A lot of freedom out there on the court and kind of positionless basketball with the team, with a lot of players that we have. So it's been fun just like learning a couple new concepts that they do differently here from New York. But it's been a seamless transition and it's been a lot of love, really.
Speaking of freedom, how much freedom you guys going to be having when you're playing with Luka and Kyrie?
Oh, man, it's going to be a lot of fun. You know, I mean, that's three guys who've been one of the best in the league at all positions, really. Hall of Famer and Clay, shooter, Kyrie, Hall of Famer, Luka, definitely going to be in the Hall of Fame. So playing with guys like that makes it easy for guys like me to just knock down shots and to play free-minded basketball.
Does it change much out there with Luka missing some time in camp?
Nah, I mean, everybody knows who he is. You know what I mean? Everybody knows what he does. So, I mean, if he's practicing with us, if he doesn't practice with us, we know when it comes game time, he's going to be ready 100%.
What's it been like getting to know and playing with Derek Lively?
Oh, it's been great. He was one of the first guys that kind of hit me up once I got traded. We were out in Vegas for about 3 or 4 days out there working out, L.A. So it's been a lot of team bonding. So it seems like I've been with you guys for like 2 or 3 years, really, because just how much fun and just how much joy everybody has every single day.
You're a good defender, but it's nice having him back there just in case.
Yeah, it's like just in case I get blown by, I know you got to go through two of us to try to get a bucket. So if you beat me, you're going to have a hell of a time to go past D-Live and Gav, too. So it's going to be a lot of fun this year.
What was your initial reaction when you were
I was super excited, because I knew most of the guys already on the team. I knew Nico and them had been trying to get me for a little while, so it was kind of good to, you know what I mean, somebody that wants you, playing with somebody that really was trying to get you. So I was just super excited and couldn't wait to get down here.
The whole
playoffs, really, the whole playoffs, watching them, had a great run, you know what I mean? So just watching them in the finals, you could tell like shooting was a little bit of a factor in that final. So hopefully me and Clay come in, giving burden off of Luka, so he didn't have to do too much out there. So like I said, just coming in, just playing my role, really.
Yesterday we saw like working on put downs. Like,
yeah.
Just what is it like being able to do that with one of the greatest shooters like ever, like most shooters?
Yeah, he's been I've been trying to talk his ear off the whole time. I mean, I'm talking to him every day. I shoot with him almost every day after practice and everything. So, I mean, he's just been like a really good mentor for me, just telling me little things on my shot, how to get an easier shot off, like pin downs. They call it the clay action for a reason. So just learning from one of the best shooters ever played just going to only elevate my game.
Part of that was, you setting the screen or him setting the screen. Just how valuable is it when a shooter is willing to set, like, high-quality screens and open the offense up for everybody else?
Yeah, you know what I mean? Just, like, somebody like that, if he's setting a screen for me, that sets an opportunity for me to slip to the basket, get an easy layup, because he's just going to draw so much attention on and off the ball. So just learning from a guy like that, I got nothing but to get better with my game.
And yesterday, Jason had mentioned that Derek Lively was posting up more than he really has, obviously, worked with his team.
Yeah, yeah.
Last year, like, just what are your thoughts on what he looked like in the post? What do you think about his potential now?
Yeah, he looked good. You know what I mean? Last year, I feel like everybody knew him kind of a little bit more so, just like a lob threat or everything around the basket. But we saw probably yesterday a couple of pin-ins, ducking into the post, a couple of right-handed hooks, left-handed hooks. So, you know what I mean? You can tell he definitely worked on his game in the summer for sure, and going to be a big help for us this season.
The word on the street is that PJ grew 2.5 inches over the summer. Now he's 6'11". Does he look 6'11 to you?
Hey, did he look 6'11 when he was walking by?
No.
I don't know, man. I mean, I'm going to just say, I'm just going off what the internet said. Y'all can take it with a grain of salt, but hey, I'll live with it. Y'all may say I'm 6'11 too by the end of the day.
What's the largest growth spurt you ever had?
Largest? I think I grew 3 inches my freshman summer. Going into my sophomore year, I was like 6'1". I grew about like 6'4-ish going into my sophomore season. So I was probably like 3 inches in the summer. Not enjoyable. Not fun.
Yeah, what? Bones, your knees.
Yeah, your knee, you know what I mean? You're hurting getting up out of bed and everything, but hey, it's worth it though. I always worth it.
Right.
Appreciate y'all.
Yesterday, Clay said you was balling out. Like, what was going on yesterday with you?
Setting the toe on first practice of the year, just trying to get my feet wet, get adjusted. This is a great first day.
How'd it go for you today?
Pretty good. Just got some shots up today. Ran through some quick sets, so everything was smooth.
Where do you see yourself fitting in with this team?
Wherever I can, wherever they need me to, in defense, offense, energy, however they need me to fit in, I can.
What have you seen so far in your time on the court with Derek Lively?
unbelievable. Big presence, obviously. Clogs the paint up. Live threat. So it's just, you know, so convenient to play with him on both sides of the ball, and I just look forward to it.
Still a big help on defense.
Oh man, like I say, clogs the paint. Defender blows by you, he's right there to, you know, help clean it up. So, like I said, I just look forward to rocking and rolling for sure.
What are some of the advantages for you playing with a guy like Luka and Kyrie and Klay? Because you know all the attention is going to be on them.
It's being open, ready to shoot. I mean, 9 times out of 10, probably I shoot a lot of more open shots than I have before. So, that's always a plus. I think I shot pretty good from the three. So, trying to shoot better this year with, you know, hopefully more open threes, it would be a plus. So,
what are your impressions so far of the rim protectors that you have with Daniel Gafford and Derrick
Watt? Like I just said to him, man, they both paint cloggers and such a so convenient if your defender beats you for them to be down there, you know, cleaning everything up. And like I said, I just can't wait to play with them.
What was that experience like for you playing with Zion?
Unbelievable. Just like Luka, superstar, generational type talent. Unbelievable, man. That's all all I can say.
He's a big dude to move real fast.
Yes, sir, gigantic.
Yeah, you were really efficient on threes last season. That was like a really strong year. What went into your consistency?
Just the work, putting in the work. Same thing I did this summer, same thing I do throughout the season. Hoping to be better even last year.
And how did that open up your game, like attacking closeouts? Is that going to help you with the rest of your game?
I think that already is my game, attacking closeouts, getting to the rim. So just being able to knock it down consistently from behind the arc, you know, I'm able to play my natural game from that. And to add that, you know, it just kind of makes me unstoppable.
What was your impression of the Mavericks while you were in New Orleans playing for the Pelicans? What was your impression of
them? It was a family-knit team. I like how well, you know, it's on the bench, everybody's cheering for everybody on the court, how together they were. And, you know, Luka and Kyrie, you know, it was the show. So,
no surprise there if we get to the finals?
No surprise. No surprise. Who can stop them, too, that many times in a row?
What's happening?
All right.
All good?
How did day two go today?
Yeah, day two was good. The non-contact practice, a lot of running, conditioning, and shooting. I thought the energy was really, really good.
Was Maxey and Kessler able to go?
No. They're a little ways away. Yeah.
What's the issue with?
Sprained ankle. So Maxey sprained his ankle, and Kessler has sprained his ankle. So both recovering from sprained ankles.
Injuries, you know, Luka obviously has a calf strain.
Yeah.
How did it happen and when did it happen?
Yeah, I think he got hit in the calf, reported it tight yesterday. And so they went got an MRI and saw that it was a strain.
Is there any concern about his level of availability throughout
preseason? No. We'll reevaluate him in a week and see where he stands. But there's no concern at this point about his availability. We'll see how he feels in a week.
So yeah, I'm assuming you missed the first preseason game, right?
That's next Monday. So
yeah,
he won't be available, or we won't look to see. We'll reevaluate in a week of where he stands and how he feels.
Derek Lively looks so far. Has he justified your position on him being the starter or co-starter?
Yeah, I think he's done great. His energy has been incredible. You know, he's ready to go. He's worked on his game. You can tell. You can see. But just his energy, his spirit. He's shooting the three well. His post-up game is really well. And then, he's just doing everything at a high level with that starting group. We'll look at Gaff starting with that starting group tonight in the second practice just to see how that looks, too.
Coach, a lot of talks about play, of course. But how about the other new guys? How'd they work so far?
Yeah, you talk about Grimes has done great. You talk about Klay. He's been his energy. He's doing all the reps, wants to do all the reps. He's been great. Both of those guys you know, can shoot the ball, but they can compete on the other end too. So they've been great. Najee, he's another newcomer. His toughness, he wants to do every rep. And so we got a lot of guys who want to, you know, not come off the floor, which is great. But those three are playing well. We're hopefully they're picking up the system on both ends. But again, they bring a lot of depth, and then also just their talent level is high. And so we're really excited to have those three.
Saw a familiar face in the gym last couple of days, Frank Vogel.
Yeah.
What's his role with the team? Is he
going to
be involved in the coaching staff?
Yeah, he's part of our coaching staff. He's a consultant for us, so he'll be in and out. He's here until, I think he's here until tomorrow. And then he'll be back with us in Dallas. And so I asked him if he can come on board and help us. Took a lot of begging, and but he was talked into it, and I'm happy he said yes.
What's that like for you to have a guy like that? You guys want to tout him in L.A. today?
Yeah, you talk about one of the best coaches in the league. You know, his basketball IQ is extremely high. We did win a championship in L.A. together. Being able to work for Frank was something that had helped me with my coaching. And so now to have him on board with us, truly, hopefully we can win another title together.
Thank you,
guys.